Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, welcome. We're the Garza Twins. I'm Carly.
And I'm Britta.
And today we're going to be talking about our favorite clean beauty products. So quick disclaimer, I know everyone defines clean as differently. When we say clean, we don't mean natural, we mean non-toxic. So all the products that
I have something natural.
Okay, I have something natural too, but I'm just saying like in general,
yeah,
it's mainly non-toxic. Mm-hmm. So it's either clean at Sephora or like one of these items is drugstore, so it's Target clean. So how the store defines clean, but we're no experts on this. Mm-hmm. We're just pulling from those different stores mm-hmm. and their lists. So first I want to talk about my favorite non-toxic eyeshadow formulas. And as you guys know, I'm allergic to talc, so I kind of gravitate towards the clean spectrum of eyeshadow at Sephora because that's the one category. It's so hard to find talc-free. And I have two favorites. This is going to be no surprise to you. I talk about them all the time. But Lawless, the Little One palette, is my, like, everyday go-to palette. Literally wear this every day. I'm not wearing it today, actually, but...
It looks the same. What are you wearing?
The Modern Renaissance?
Oh, you still have that?
Yeah.
Oh,
my God. I just decided to pull it out. I just wanted to use what I had, you know? And I literally use this every day. So if you're watching another video of ours, I'm probably wearing this on my eyes. I love it. They have the best shades for everyday use. I love that it's 6 mattes, 2 shimmers. It's like such a good ratio. It's so inexpensive. I think it's like $25. Mm-hmm. You can get it at Sephora. It's blendable. I have spoken about this in depth, and you do have to like blend like more than other shadow formulas. My favorite thing about it is how long that these shadows last on the lids. So once you get them blended out, they're there. They're there all day. They don't like fade away, which is another pet peeve of mine when it comes to eyeshadow. And then the other palettes I love are the Ilia, what are these called? The Necessary Eyeshadow Palette in Warm Nude and Cool Nude. I have them both because I had to get them both. I love this packaging. This is so pretty. These are
the palettes. The packaging's really nice.
Yeah, they're both 6 pan. I love them both. I think I wear the Warm Nude a little bit more, but I wear them both. This one, like, it doesn't look like purple on the eyes, you know? It just looks like a cool tone neutral. I feel like they did such a good job curating these colors. The formula is definitely more blendable. I prefer the Ilia formula. I've spoken about this before, too. The Ilia formula is my favorite eyeshadow formula, but I just love the color story happening in the Lawless Little One, so I just use that one more because I love, like, how the shades are truly neutral. You know, we have warm and cool. I actually, if they came out with a neutral nude palette, I would lose my mind because these are amazing. The formula blends itself. It's so effortless. The shimmers, like, again, last all day on the lid. They're so, so good. You would never even know that they're really clean mm-hmm. because they perform like any other high-end shadow. Mm-hmm. And I love this brand. Obviously, you'll see some other things from them.
And that's kind of how we don't seek out clean products generally.
No, except for the eyeshadow, yeah.
But, these are just things that we've tried and, like, ended up loving.
Yeah,
and then we
yeah.
just had tried enough that we're like, oh, we should do a video.
Mm-hmm. I know there are a lot of people that are trying to, like, transition into mm-hmm. clean beauty solely. And we're not those people, but... I'm just kind of like perplexed at how far this whole mm-hmm. like sector of the beauty industry has come. Mm-hmm. And so we just wanted to share our favorites with mm-hmm. you.
I have an Ilia product too. This is the Ilia, what's the stick highlighter? I think it's just called the Illuminator because mm-hmm. it was one of their original products and their names weren't as like fancy yet.
Yeah.
It's the Illuminator and this shade is actually, it's Stella by Starlight, which is like the third or fourth shade, but it works really well for my skin tone. I can swatch it here. We can insert some swatches too, but it's so reflective and pretty.
Like, yeah, that's really pretty.
I know, it's such a beautiful shade. The formula, this is how, I don't know how to describe it, but you can tell it's natural, if that makes sense. Like, it smells kind of like a mango butter or like some sort of butter.
Oh yeah, you can definitely tell it's like a...
Yeah, and then like when you feel it, you can tell it has like a bit of like a thickness to it, like a little bit of viscosity. Where again, it's like coming from some sort of butter in the formula, mm-hmm. but once it goes on your skin, like I just put a brush in here and kind of just like dab it on and blend it out. And once it's blended out, it looks like any other like stunning stick highlighter, in my opinion. Like I love the Hourglass stick highlighters, and I feel like this is almost like just as good and up there with that one. And this is like clean, and
yeah,
it's really, really impressive. This was something that they sent us, and I didn't really think much of it, and then I started using it, and I love it. And actually, every time I wear it, I get a lot of compliments, too. Mm-hmm. So, definitely one of my favorite stick highlighter formulas. I love it.
Okay, just to close up, the Ilia, the Ilia trio of our favorite Ilia products.
The Ilia Limitless Mascara lives up to the hype.
It's so good.
We don't generally, well, I guess I should speak for myself because I know you love the CoverGirl Mascara. I don't generally like molded wands because I poke my eye with them. Mm-hmm. I find that they're not as flexible, so they can't like move with your lashes as easily. So I generally just don't buy them. But this, for whatever reason, is so good. I like the formula. I would say it's a drier formula, which I prefer, don't you think?
I think it's actually
pretty wet. Not at first. Like, I think when you first use it, it's pretty wet. And then I like when it dries out a little bit, personally.
Yeah, it's like in the middle. I actually don't think it's too dry.
That CoverGirl one is way
dry. No, it's not too dry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I guess it's in the middle. Like, you know how there's some mascaras that are so wet that they just take forever to dry down? I absolutely hate those. And then I prefer, like, you guys know, the L'Oreal Voluminous, I love. And that one's so dry that sometimes it dries down almost too fast and, like, you have to work really quickly or it doesn't last as long. Like, it gets too dry for your eyes to use. So this, I would say, like, you're right. It is somewhere in the middle. And it's very black and it coats the lashes really evenly. It doesn't make them look clumpy, but you can still build it up to get volume, which is always what I'm after.
I feel like we both curl our lashes before applying mascara. And this one, like, it doesn't drop your lashes at all, and it kind of just like elegantly coats what you have going on. Like, it looks beautiful,
but you can build it up to be pretty like
definitely. Again, something that I've been complimented on, like my lashes when I wear this. So, and I had to buy the mini because I had a mini in a set that I bought and then I couldn't live without it, so I and that's so unlike me because I'm like, oh, I'll just pick up a drugstore mascara. But I was like, honestly, the mini lasted me like 2 months, and then you kind of have to replace mascara
after 3 months,
anyway.
You should replace it anyway.
So,
I think they only have the one shade after midnight.
Yeah, which is really cute.
But it's good. I see why it's really like a hero product of theirs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so next up is a product that I bought from Ulta, and since Ulta doesn't have a clean standard, I looked up the ingredient list, and it seemingly would pass Sephora Clean or like any of the clean lists. Because it's 100% naturally derived. But do your own research, obviously. But everything on this list, I can understand. It seems very natural. So I don't see any reason why it wouldn't pass like a Sephora Clean. But this is the Frank Body Illuminator. And now they don't sell it on Ulta. So I'm going to have to link it down on the Frank Body website. Because for some reason, they don't sell it there. But this was so unassuming. But I heard on like a Reddit thread or somewhere that it was an exact dupe for RMS Living Luminizer. But like half the cost and twice the amount of product. So I picked it up. And I am obsessed with this. Again, it's one of those illuminators. Like,
can I feel it?
Yeah, like I can tell that there's like some... Again, like oils and like
definitely
natural
oils.
Yeah, oils happening. But the end beauty look is so like stunning and on par with just like, here, this is like,
yeah, that's really
splotchy.
Pretty.
Yeah, so on par with any like just a stunning illuminator that I don't think of it as like, it's like shocking to me that it's 100% naturally derived. And there's a lot of coconut oil in here, I believe, but it hasn't broken me out. And if you like a glossy highlight, like something that just gives your face like a glossy, natural, like lit from within glow, definitely go this road because it just gives you that beautiful look. I actually bought this kind of recently, so I haven't gotten to use it in the summer, but I'm really excited for that because I feel like it's just a beautiful like summery look. Like if you go on like a beach vacations, this would be like such a pretty highlight to take with you. Yeah, really, really impressive for 100% natural product. Like I don't think I've ever liked a 100% natural product as much as I like this. Speaking of 100% natural products, so again, this is listed as Target Clean, like they have the little clean emblem, but it's also natural. Do your own research because it's like Sephora has such a cut and dry list
that
it's like so easy to tell on there, but the other retailers, it's a bit more difficult, but these have been fine for me and it says they're 100% natural, but they also have the clean emblem. They're the Burt's Bees blushes and I've spoken about these before, maybe not in quite some time, but these are something I still use like at least once a week. I love them. I have all three shades. This is Bare Peach, and then we have Toasted Cinnamon, which is like a deeper nude, and then this pink shade is Shy Pink, and I hope they expand the range because I think this formula is so beautiful. It's so silky on the skin. It blends out really well. It's buildable. Like, it's not too much pigment right away. The colors are really, really nice and flattering, I feel like, on any skin tone. They're only like $10. It's such a good formula. I can't believe it's natural, first of all. They're really, really good. My favorite drugstore blushes, hands down, but like also just one of my favorite blushes in general. So definitely check these out.
Okay, and last but not least, this is the Lawless Seal the Deal Loose Setting Powder. And this came in a little kit. I believe I spoke about it. It was, did you get that kit too?
Mm-mm.
Oh, it was a Sephora Clean, like, favorites kit. And I got the kit specifically because this powder was in there. And it's the travel size of the full-size version. Mm-hmm. So, like, for a few dollars more, you got the kit that had, like, the small Ilia mascara. It was a really good assortment of products. But when I tried this, I just was really, really surprised with how much I liked it. I generally, like, I mean, now I've been using the Hourglass powder, and I really, really love that. But I still use this powder to set my under eyes because it's almost like a banana shade, as you can see. What is the shade called? It's called Classic Translucent, but it does have, like, a bit of a yellow color.
There's a tint.
It's yeah.
Translucent.
Yeah. So I love that it helps to brighten up my under eyes. So, and it's not too heavy to wear under the eyes. Like, I would look at a powder like this that's similar to maybe, like, the Laura Mercier, mm-hmm. which I can't wear because it has talc, but people love that. And I would think, like, oh, that might be a little heavy for under the eyes, but I use this under my eyes, and it doesn't look cakey. I mean, obviously use it sparingly, like, with how I have dry skin, so I just try to use powder sparingly. But it's really, really beautiful. It sets everything in place. It gives, like, a very blurring effect to the skin. It doesn't look cakey, like I said. If I set it with setting spray and, like, press my sponge in, I feel like you can't even tell that I'm wearing powder if I use it in the right way. And this small size, let's see, it's 10 grams. I feel like it's lasted me quite some time. Yes. So I would say to buy this one. Yeah, don't buy the full size. Like, try this one out. They have it on Sephora. It's a really good powder. I feel like a lot of people don't really speak about Lawless. I hope that, like, she finds more of an audience, mm-hmm. but no one really talks about this powder, and I'm just very surprised by it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you're interested in more, like, clean type videos, we can definitely try to do those, mm-hmm. like a skincare or something like that, so let us know.